Hi, this is Bill from CNCRouterTips.com, and one of our listeners asked how to import 3D models into Vectric Aspire. To start, we would first open Aspire and then create a new file. Once we did that, we could enter in information about the size in units, whether inches or millimeters, the width, the height, or the thickness. In this case, we're using a 75 millimeter wide by 125 millimeter high by 75 millimeters thick piece of material. We go ahead and click OK, and that will create a 2D block that represents the size of the material that we're going to use for our model. Now, we found a model of the Thomas the Tank Engine on Thingiverse.com, and since we talked about modeling Thomas, I thought it would be appropriate to go ahead and create one for Thomas the Tank Engine. So we scrolled down and we found the assembled Thomas the Train.stl file, and we downloaded that and we saved a copy to our hard drive. And once we did that, we are able to go in and grab that file and bring it into Aspire. So back in Aspire, we go to the File menu and scroll down to Import. And then we import component or 3D model. That'll take us into our downloads folder, and we can find the assembled Thomas the Train STL file and load that in. And we get a 3D representation of the model that's brought in, and a wireframe of the block of material that it's going to fit into. And with that, we can set the parameters on how we would like the model to be represented and which position we want it in the block. We can have it from the bottom, the top, the left side, the right side, the back of the 3D model, and the front of the 3D model. And that may not be relevant to how the model was displayed, but how the model was created. So we can also rotate the model around 90 degrees, 180 degrees in any direction. We just use the radio buttons, and that makes it happen. Another feature is we can interactively rotate the model using all three coordinates. You just drag it after you've clicked the XYZ radio button, and you can drag it in any direction, and when you let go, it will be in that position relative to the zero plane. You can also rotate just one axis at a time, the x-axis for instance. And again, it's the x-axis of the 3D model, not necessarily the x-axis of your work area. You can also rotate it back to where it was and it will reset. Or you can do the same thing in the y-axis, rotate it around the y-axis of the machine so that you could get at different sides of the material. And lastly, you can rotate it around the z-axis. These would come in handy when you want to position the model in an angle that's not commonly seen, just to create a new variety of part. Now, about the model size, you can change the model size relative to the material and relative to the 3D model. If you have the lock XY coordinates set, any changes you make to any of the three boxes X, Y, or Z will scale it appropriately and so it'll keep the same basic scale. You can also change the scale from inches to millimeters and back again automatically, and it'll do the calculation for you. You just have to keep in mind it doesn't care what size your material is when you do that, so you have to take control of that. Now at the bottom you'll notice this gray rectangle that the model is sitting on, and that's the zero plane, and you can manipulate where the cutter will cut in relationship to that model, in the middle, the top, or the bottom. And in fact, sometimes when you're setting these up, you might want to pick a handy surface, a flat surface, and align the plane with that, because it will be easier when you're doing your final cutting to have a flat surface to reference off of. If you click the discard all data below the zero plane or the create both sides button, it will do just that. If you discard the data, it will get rid of anything that was going to be cut beneath that zero plane, and if you use the other, it will create two files for you. Now, one thing that we see here is that we're doing apply perspective along the Z plane, and this allows us to change the perspective of the model and create some cartoon-like features just by moving that slider. I'm not really sure what I would use that for, but it is really cool. And you know, stretching out the train and seeing how that reacts. When you get the model the way you want it, just hit OK, and it will create the 3D model in Aspire for you. And it'll calculate it, and it will generate a reference inside of the modeling tree. And here's the preview of what the model will cut. You'll notice that some of the detail on the sides is gone, and that is because you're only machining one side of the part. You can create a bounding vector around the part, which will allow you to choose what you machine. And we just did that. And once you select that, you can go over to the Toolpaths tab, and you can select a finished toolpath. I'm just going to go with the defaults for now and select a 1/8 inch end mill bit from my list of tools, and then I'm going to hit calculate. It begins the calculations of the toolpaths, and it will generate the toolpaths, and we can see what it finally creates when we look at, in the 3D view. It'll show a preview of what the toolpaths look like. You can see all those little blue lines are where the bit's going to move back and forth over the surface of the material in order to create your 3D object. Now we can preview what this is going to look like by previewing the selected toolpaths, and we'll show you an animation of the cutter removing the material. Unfortunately, I've selected a black plastic material to show this, and it may be difficult for you to see, but it is cutting back and forth across the material to create this 3D object. Now, the interesting part about this whole thing is you're not stuck with this preview in this dark material. You can change all of that if you like to something that's a little bit easier to see, and I'll show you that as soon as the preview is done. Okay, you could come up to the preview toolpath and you could select once you select the model for the 3D finish, you're able to go in and select what material you want it to show and what color material you want to use. In this case, we're going to switch to white. which may be a little easier to see. Now the preview was cut with that black toolpath and it still shows in that. But you can clearly see the top of Thomas the Tank Engine cut out of this part. And we can close that preview and it'll give us a wooden version of what that's going to look like. And you can see it compared to the grayscale. You get the 3D object. Now we're going to create another 3D toolpath of the material. We just want to recalculate it again so you can see a little bit better in this view what the toolpaths itself look like. And it begins calculating the toolpaths again. And when it's finished, it'll display the blue lines to indicate where the cutter is going to cut, and a green line to indicate where it's plunging, and red lines for rapid moves. So you may be able to see it plunge, do a rapid over, plunge down, and start at the back of the engine, and then cuts all the way forward, and then it does a move up to the top. And as this is previewing the cut, you can make changes if you like. You can go back in and you can see where you're going to have problem areas in your cut. So it's always a good idea to use the preview. And one nice thing about being able to preview what is going to be cut is you can send a copy of the preview image to a customer to get approval before you waste time cutting valuable material. So that can come in very handy. Now when you select the toolpath, you get to see the lines. Otherwise you don't see them. You notice we don't see the toolpath from the previous cut that we did. It's just the one that is currently selected. We're going to enlarge the view so you can just see the 3D model. Okay, if we come back over to close, we can close out this file and recap. So the basic steps are, we set up the job size, we import our 3D component, in this case we got this one from Thingiverse, then we orient the model, we choose the size, and I'm going to show you something different here. We turned off the lock XYZ and just scaled the Z height. And you can see the engine is squished down on the top compared to what it was before. So it's a really cool way to be able to manipulate the same 3D model. Okay, and we're going to create the cut plane for this one, drop it down in the same relative position, but this time beneath the wheels, and we calculate what we want to cut. So you can see it would cut out a different profile than before. So if we want, we can go over to the toolpath and we can have it create a vector around the 3D model. We can select that vector and create a finished toolpath. And that finished toolpath, we get a chance to align it in the model and then calculate it. And again, the calculation may take a moment, a minute, or more to complete. But once it does, you're ready to go ahead and generate your G-code from that toolpath so that you could go and cut the part. But this is a totally different model, a totally different look from the same model. But it won't be as proportionately accurate as the original was. This one is a squished down top. We can see here we're previewing the cut tool path. And if you want to stop the preview, you can click that red X that was down at the bottom of the preview screen and it'll stop. And if you start up the preview again, it'll eventually pick right up where it left off before. Or you could reset the preview and start from scratch. You can select a different model material to preview it in. Here it is in cherry, dark oak. What's nice about Aspire is if you have a particular piece of wood that you want to use, you can take a picture of it and load in that preview material and preview it and what your actual wood would look like. So something to keep in mind for the future. Okay, if you'd like to see more videos like this or have a question about this video, you can contact me at cncroutertips.com, or you can listen to our podcast, the CNC Router Tips Podcast, and we'll try and help you with your CNC questions and cut through the confusion. If you go to cncroutertips.com, you can subscribe to our free newsletter. You can also listen to episodes of the podcast at cncroutertips.com/podcast. Please leave an honest review or a comment for this video. It really helps to know that if this is helpful to others, that it's really a nice way to let me know. Thank you. Have a great day.